Good morning all, Dr. Saif Shinde here. Today I'm going to talk about the introductory part of the thermodynamics examination scheme, content of the subject, various assessment methods that are being employed in the subject. And in addition, we are going to take a look at the content of the syllabus also. The outcomes, what you are going to get at the end of the course, that also we are going to talk about. And PO attainment. Ultimate goal of the graduating with the mechanical engineering degree. So let's begin with the examination scheme. The examination scheme is like the subject is basically a program core course having 4 credits. The teaching hours allotted to this subject are like 3 theory hours per week and 1 tutorial will be there. The examination scheme is like 20, 20, 60. 20 marks for continuous assessment, 20 marks for mid-semester examination, and 60 marks are there for end-semester examination. The end-semester examination will be of 3 hours. Now, content of the subject. There are total 5 units. Till last semester, there were 6 units. But this semester, the subject has got modified. They have removed 1 unit, that is availability, and they have added another unit, that is properties of pure substance. It was there in the last semester, but this time they have made as a separate unit. In addition to that, they have merged 2 units, that is second law of thermodynamics and entropy, and they have made that as a unit number 3. So unit number 1, we'll be talking about the fundamental concepts and definitions. The basic concepts that are going to be like introductory things to the thermodynamics. What is the system, types of system, the various approaches that are being applied to study the thermodynamics. Then various properties that are important in case of thermodynamics, then categories of those properties like point function, path function, intensive properties, extensive properties. Then we'll be talking about thermodynamic equilibrium. What is mean by thermodynamic equilibrium, or when we can say that the system is under thermodynamic equilibrium, that we'll be talking about. The next part of the unit number 1 is work and heat transfer. We know that Joules has performed 1 experiment and proved that work and heat are interconvertible. The conversion rates are obviously different because one is high grade energy and other is low grade energy, but those two are interconvertible. And in this unit, we are going to study that conversion and the systems involved in that conversion. Additionally, we'll be studying the zeroth law of thermodynamics. That is the basis of temperature measurement. So after studying that in zeroth law, we'll be studying some temperature measuring instruments, their working principles and applicability. And also we'll be talking about specific heat and latent heat, what is mean by those two terms. And in addition, we'll be talking about specific heat at constant pressure and constant volume, that is Cp and Cv. Then unit number 2, that is first law of thermodynamics, teaching hours are 7, just like unit number 1. In unit number 2, we'll be studying about the first law of thermodynamics applied to closed system, that is undergoing cycle and change of state. Then we'll be talking about energy, types of energy, enthalpy, and PMM1, that is the system or instrument that violates the first law of thermodynamics, and that is PMM1, perpetual motion machine of first kind, that we'll be talking about. Then we are going to apply the first law of thermodynamics to steady flow processes and the instruments working on those processes like nozzle, turbine, compressor, pump, boiler, throttling valve, etc. So that is unit number 2. Unit number 3 is, as I said, this is combination of 2 units. If we follow the previous syllabus, that is second law of thermodynamics and entropy. But now those two are combined together. Content has got no change at all. So this is quite vast unit. So first part is second law of thermodynamics. The start of the unit will be with limitations of first law. As we know that first law says that energy cannot be created nor destroyed, it can be converted from one form to another. But we know that that conversion is not possible all the time. Like there are certain situations, under those situations only that conversion is possible. That direction of conversion also has to be defined, and first law never talks about that. That is limitation, and we'll be talking about that limitation here. Then cyclic heat engine, refrigerator, heat pump, those three devices we are going to talk about. In case of second law of thermodynamics, there are basically two statements, Kelvin-Planck statement and Clausius statement. Kelvin-Planck deals with the heat engine and Clausius statement deals with the heat transfer. We'll be talking about those two statements in the detail in upcoming sessions. Now we are going to study their equivalence also. Then see if we create a device that violates the Kelvin-Planck statement, then ultimate result is going to be violation of Clausius statement also, and vice versa. A violation of either of those two will violate the other also. Then we'll be talking about reversibility and irreversibility, Carnot cycle, Carnot theorem, absolute thermodynamic temperature scale, how that thermodynamics temperature scale came into existence, what is the basic principle that has been applied to define that thermodynamic temperature scale, that we'll be talking about. The next one is entropy. Entropy, what is mean by entropy? That's the introduction part, introductory part. Then Clausius theorem, temperature entropy plot, TS plot, Clausius inequality. Then entropy and irreversibility, how entropy decides the irreversibility of the process or its effect on the irreversibility, that we'll be talking about. Entropy principle and its application. Entropy principle, that is quite important thing that we'll be talking about, that entropy of the universe always keep on increasing till it reaches its maximum value. That's the basically entropy principle that we are going to study. Then combine first and second law. And two important things, entropy and direction, and entropy and disorder. Those two are quite important terms related to this unit that we'll be talking about. Then unit number four is basically based on ideal gases. This unit might be quite familiar to you all, that because you might have studied in the 11th or 12th standards also. So we'll be dealing with the Boyle's law, Charles' law, Avogadro's law, universal gas constant, ideal processes related with the ideal gases, and various equations of the states. Then last unit, that is based on properties of the pure substance. Basically, we are going to study processes related to steam, their phase change phenomena, then phase diagram, PVTS, HS diagrams, that is the pressure volume, temperature entropy, enthalpy entropy diagrams for steam itself. Then critical point, what is mean by critical point, what exact situation is there, why we call it critical point, then similarly triple point, then their property table, and lastly the representation of those processes on PVTS diagrams. We are going to also calculate the dryness fraction and their measurement techniques. Dryness fraction is nothing but the moisture content of the steam. When we convert water into steam, initially we never get the dry steam. There will be some amount of water content that is nothing but moisture, and that is defined in terms of dryness fraction. So this is the content for our subject. Now this is quite important thing. Outcomes. What you are going to get at the end of this course, why you are studying it. So you might have heard about Bloom's taxonomy, NBA program outcomes, or graduate attributes defined by Washington Accord. If you have ever heard about those things, then you can relate this course outcome easily. If you haven't heard about it previously, then I'll suggest take a look of those things at least for once. That is going to be quite helpful. So as there are 5 units, I have written 5 COs. So situation is like one CO dealing with the one unit. So CO1, the statement is like CO will be basically it is a thing that you are going to able to do once you are done with that unit or once you have studied that unit. So statement of CO1 is student will be able to. Now what student are going to be able to? Define the terms like system boundary properties, equilibrium, work, heat, ideal gas, entropy, etc. We have seen the curriculum of unit number 1. So now if you read the statement, do you find that you will be able to do this? You must be. If you are not able to do that, then you need to study that unit again till you are going to be able to do this or you have achieved this CO, right? You need to study until you achieve this CO2. Student will be able to apply basic laws of thermodynamics to simple thermal system. What systems? Like piston cylinder arrangement, compressor, pump, refrigerator, heat exchanger. Yes, we are going to study all those systems in first law of thermodynamics when we apply steady flow energy equation to study the energy balance, right? So you will be able to do this to analyze the energy balance. Yes, obviously we are going to do that. So you must be able to do this also. COT, student will be able to describe the limitations of first law. Actually, this is related to unit number 3, that is second law thermodynamics, that begins with the limitations of first law. So student will be able to describe the limitations of first law of thermodynamics and apply second law of thermodynamics to various thermodynamic systems. Yes, we are going to do that. You will be able to do that if you study it in a proper manner. CO4, student will be able to explain the concept of entropy and apply it to find the reversibility of various thermodynamic processes. Also, actually, CO3 and part of CO4 are from unit number 3 that deals with the second law of thermodynamics and entropy, as that unit has got a bit of a more syllabus compared to other units. So I have made 2 separate COs for those 2, and CO4 has got part of unit number 3 as well as part of unit number 4 also. So statement is the student will be able to explain the concept of entropy and apply it to find the reversibility of various thermodynamic processes. Also describe the processes like isothermal, adiabatic process, etc. for ideal gas and to present them on PV and TS plus. So that is for ideal gases. Last CO, CO number 5. Student will be able to represent phase diagram of pure substance, that is steam, on different thermodynamic planes like pressure, volume, temperature, entropy, enthalpy, entropy, etc. and show various constant property lines on them. Actually, while writing those COs, I have tried to begin with the lowest level of the learning. If you have ever heard about the Bloom's taxonomy, various psychological domains of learning, then there are 4 domains: cognitive, related to mental activities, psychomotor domains, related to physical activities, then affective domain, that is related to changes in your behavior and attitude. And last one is spiritual domain. So the first important domain is cognitive domain, that starts with the basic or simple thing that is remembering the concepts. Then remembering the concept, next is understanding, then apply, ideal. Then analyzing the things, by applying the concepts, then evaluating, and last one is creating. That is the highest level of the learning. So I have tried to follow this scenario over here. Now, this is something related to program outcomes defined by the NBA. NBA is a National Board of Accreditation that defines and governs the quality of engineering education. And they have written 12 statements related to knowledge or various skills and the changes that are going to occur in the graduating student once he is done with the graduation program or when he is going to appear in the market. These things are supposed to have attained by him. So what are things? He should have technical knowledge of the branch. Suppose you are going to be a mechanical engineer, so you need to have that mechanical engineering knowledge. With that knowledge, you should be able to apply that knowledge to solve the problems. So problem analysis skills should be there. You should be able to carry out investigations. When you expose to certain problem in the industry, you need to investigate the causes. Then only you are going to get the solution. So that ability you should have, and that will be possessed by you while being graduated with the mechanical engineering. Then designing the solutions, to design those solutions, applying the modern tools. Then when you are industry or even in while graduating also, you need to work in team. You are not going to work alone, never. So you should have that team building capacity, or you need to have that ability to work in the team. Then communication skills. You might have heard about this thing that as long as you have a technical skill, you need not to be worried about communication skill. But that not true. When you have certain idea in your mind, you should be able to communicate that idea to another person. That's the important, right? If you could not communicate it, then it doesn't have got any worth. Then professionalism, professionals, ethics, lifelong learning, how you are going to utilize that skill, knowledge to your whole life, how your work is going to impact the society, ethics and quality. Ethics are quite important. You should pay equal attention to ethics also. If you have got the very good technical knowledge and you don't have ethics, what will happen? You will become another terrorist. Right? Those are technical persons, but they have got no ethics. So having ethics is also important. And last is economics and project management. There has to be some wealth generation, right? That is the most important. So these 12 statements you are going to have at the end of the at the end of your graduation. When you are going to be graduated, you are going to have all those skills. But scenario is not like overnight you are going to get all these skills. No. When you enter in the graduation, like in first year itself, till first year to the final year, you are going to achieve these 12 things in part. In part, why I'm saying in part? Because you are, let's talk about our subject, thermodynamics. When you are going to study thermodynamics, you are going to attain those 5 things that we have written on the last slide over here, right? So these 5 things are going to contribute to some of those 12 statements, and that to part of those statements. Means if you achieve, suppose this CO1, you may achieve part of this knowledge base, part of this problem analysis, or part of something else. And when you study those various courses available to you for the duration of 4 years of your graduation, ultimately you are going to attain these 12 statements. So that attainment or that mapping has been prescribed over here. This is CO1 for the thermodynamics, and these are the 12 statements related to these 12 things. So when you are going to done with the thermodynamics subject, you are when you attain the CO1 that we have written, then you are going to attain the part of PO1, you are going to attain the part of PO7, and you are going to attain the part of PO2. Similarly, CO2, 3, 4, 5, are going to help you to attain part of those 12 POs. You might find that PO3, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10, 11 has not got referred by any of these POs. Right. It might be there. For to attain those POs, there might be some additional subject there in second year, in third year, or in final year also. But the ultimate goal is when you study those various courses available for your graduation, you need to attain all these 12 statements. Not to same extent, maybe higher extent, maybe lower extent, but you are going to attain all these 12 statements. Now the last part, textbooks. University has prescribed two textbooks, Engineering Thermodynamics by P.K. Nag and Thermodynamics and Engineering Approach by Senjal and Bowles. In addition to those two books, I will suggest one more book, Textbook of Engineering Thermodynamics by R.K. Rajput. That is also a good textbook. You can refer that also. And two reference books are also there, Fundamentals of Thermodynamics by Wallin and Sontag, and Fundamentals of Engineering Thermodynamics by Moron and Shapiro. So we are going to end our first session over here, and we'll meet in the next session. There we'll be starting with our unit number 1, that is actual curriculum.